So good morning one and all. So let us start today's class. In the last class we have started with function of two random variables. So we told that we started with z equal to x plus y. So here what happens here? We know the pdef of x, pdef of y. We want pdef of z. What do we want? Pdef of z. Finally, this is what we want. So to find out this, first we find out CDF, fz of z. What is the basic definition of CDF? Probability that z is less than equal to z. So we proceeded like this. So finally what we got? We got two formulas for CDF, PDF, sorry, fz of z. What are they? Integration minus to plus infinity f x y of x comma y of x z minus x dx. So the simple way to remember is here we are integrating with respect to x, isn't it? So that's why everything should be in the function of x only. We know that here x plus y equal to z. X is x only, but what is y here? Y is nothing but z minus x. So in this way you should remember. So what is one more formula? Suppose if I integrate with respect to y, y should remain same, you replace x. Now what is x from this? Z minus y. Okay, so you will write z minus y as it is, because we are integrating with respect to. I told you one more important thing regarding this. If they are independent, if x and y are independent, obviously we know the condition of independence. Okay, then what happens? Finally, so let me write f z of z equal to, simply I will write minus 2 plus infinity f x of x and fi of z minus x dx. This is one more formula, or there is one more formula, that is minus 2 plus infinity. What is that? Fx of, what is that? Fx of z minus y. Z minus y fi of y dy. Fi of y dy. Anyway, both are equal to something called fx of z convolution fi of z. So this is very very important. If x and y are happen to be independent, so the pdf of sum of those two random variables is convolution of their corresponding pdfs. Okay, now so let us proceed for another case. Case 2. What is that? Z equal to difference of two random variables, x minus y. Z equal to difference of two random variables. Now here, before that, here I have defined for discrete random variable also. If you remember, here there also, that is also convolution. We have solved one problem also, right? Otherwise, let me write here for a discrete random variable. What have you written there? Remember properly. For discrete case, what is written? So the PMF of z equal to, what is written? Convolution of two PMFs. So we have solved one problem also. You go and check. Okay. Right. So let us move on to our present case, that is z equal to difference between two random variables x comma y. Okay, now same thing here also, we want fz of z, but first we calculate CDF. Okay, now what we do here? Capital fz of z equal to, so let me start with the basic definition, probability that z is less than equal to z. But what is z? X minus y. So this is equal to probability that x minus y is less than or equal to z. Okay. Now let us draw a graph. What is the graph? This is a graph. Okay. So let us draw x minus y equal to z. This line indicates x minus y equal to z. Okay. Now what we want? X minus y is less than z. What is the area? Which area you would integrate? So to the left hand side of this line, x minus y is less than z means this region. This is a region of integration. So this indicates x minus y is less than equal to z. Next. So what we do generally? We take a strip, horizontal strip. Okay. So we integrate over this strip along x-axis. This is x-axis, this is y-axis. So what is the inner integral first? Let me draw here. So x varies from where to where? Minus infinity to here. What is x? Z plus y. Now what happens? So the c def equal to first, what is inner integral? We are integrating with respect to x. X square is from minus infinity to z plus y. Then f x comma y of x comma y dx. Next, what about y integration? We are integrating over all y. You swipe this strip along y axis. So it takes all possible values. So that is y is from minus infinity to plus infinity dy. So if you apply Leibniz rule, I am not writing all rules here. If apply Leibniz rule for this, so what do you get? You get like this. It is integration minus to plus infinity x comma y of z plus y comma y dy. This is very, very important. Okay, now no need to remember any formula. Why? Because we are integrating with respect to y. So that's why. So you must keep everything in place of y. Here, what is x minus y equal to? Z. But what is x equal to? Z plus y. In place of x, write z plus y. Keep y as it is. So integrate with respect to y. Okay. Now again, if they are independent, if x and y are independent, what do you write? Simple. Independent means joint PDF becomes product of two marginal PDFs. Now finally it becomes minus to plus infinity fx of z plus y into fy of y dy. Okay. So this is about x minus y. Okay, so so you solve this problem. This is about same problem, that is homework, very, very important. I just now told you the formula for x minus y, you solve. Okay, so let us move on to one more, that is z equal to x by y. Z equal to x by y. Now here, so we will determine what fz of z, quite obvious. Otherwise in terms of small variables, z equal to x by y, otherwise x equal to z y. Okay. Now here what we want actually? We want c dep of z that equal to probability that z is less than equal to z. That is also equal to probability that what is that? X by y. Now here what happens here is this ratio x by y equal to z. Now it implies x equal to what now? X equal to what now? Y z. But this is true if y is positive. If y is negative, what happens? Y is negative, what happens? Sorry, this is I have written. Okay. Now here, I should take x minus y, x by y less than equal to z. Now we are talking about this ratio, right? So then this implies x is less than equal to z into y if y is greater than 0. Then if y is negative, what happens? X will be greater than equal to y z if y is what? Less than 0. So there are two events. This event A, let us take this event A complement. Is it okay? Now, here what happens? Now we have this equation which we discuss here. Now I will write here. So we need to find out two probabilities. What are they? Probability that x is less than equal to zy if this is true if y is greater than 0 plus next probability that x is greater than equal to yz if y is what? Negative. Now I have divided into two separate probabilities. Why? Because they are, suppose what is A union A complement here? That is overall set, universal set. So this is for y greater than 0, this is a condition. For y less than 0, this is a condition. Are you getting what I'm saying? So let me go from the starting. Z equal to x by y. Z equal to x by y. So c dep of z equal to probability that z is less than equal to small z. But what is z? Z is x by y. This x by y less than equal to z or x less than equal to zy if y is positive. If y is negative, this inequality reverses. X greater than equal to yz if y is negative. Now we are writing this combinedly as a plus because they are disjoint events. Okay. Now, so let us draw the graph. This is a graph. This is x. This is y. Okay. Here what we want? So we want this here we should be x less than equal to yz and x less than equal to yz and y is positive. And y is positive. So this is line represents x equal to yz. That is the slope. X equal to yz. Okay. Is it okay? Now, what is this? This is the region of our interest. Why? Because here what we are saying, y is positive means above the x-axis. In this region, y is positive, isn't it? Y is positive, this is the region. Next, x is less than or equal to yz means to the left side of this line means this region. So what is the common region? This region. This is a region which is common for both conditions. Now here, let me write here. So what about y varies? Y varies from where to where? 0 to infinity. Okay. What about this horizontal strip? So we have to find the probability over this strip along x-axis. Means it varies from minus infinity to here. What is x? Y z. Now the limits of this strip are minus infinity to y z. What about limits of y? 0 to infinity. Isn't it? Now, so let us take, this is for this case. Okay. So let us take another case. You think of another case. This case. What will happen here? Yeah. So here, this is x. This is y. Okay. Now, y should be negative. So here what we want? X greater than yz. Here we want x should be greater than or equal to yz. At the same time, y should be negative. Y is negative means what is that? Below the x-axis. Y is negative here. Next, this is x equal to yz line. Okay, x should be greater than yz means to the right side of this line. Greater than means right side of this line. This is a region. Now this is a region which is satisfying both the conditions. Now what about limits of, now here also taken a horizontal strip. What about the limits of this strip? What is that? Here, what is the value of x? That is yz. Here to infinity. What are the limits of y? What are the limits of y? Here y is negative, which means minus infinity to 0. Okay, let me write here. So properly here. So here probability that x is less than yz given y is greater than 0 plus probability that x is greater than yz given y is negative. So here we have drawn two separate graphs because see I told you we deal with graphs only here. That is very important. For this, what is that integration? First, let me go to this graph. So let us do integration with respect to x. Limits of x are from where to where? Minus infinity to yz. So x equal to minus infinity to yz f xy of x comma y dx. What are the limits of y from the first graph? Y is from 0 to infinity. Y is from 0 to infinity dy. This is for first probability. For next probability, plus next probability, what are the limits of x? What are the limits of from the second graph? Yz to infinity. X equal to yz to infinity fx comma y of x comma y dx. What are the limits of y? Y varies from minus infinity to 0 because y is negative. It is minus infinity to 0 dy. Here, so if you solve them, so using Leibniz rule, what you get here is fz of z equal to y equal to 0 to infinity y into fxy of yz comma, sorry, yz comma y dy. So this is the final answer. Okay, so let us start with another topic now. Yeah, before that, they are called something called ordered statistics. Means here we find out, suppose z equal to maximum of two random variables. So w equal to minimum of two random variables. They are called ordered statistics. So let us go with maximum of two random variables. Now, suppose what do you write here? Z equal to, let me elaborate this, x, small x I am writing, if x is greater than y. If x is more, z would be x only, because it is nothing but maximum of two random variables. Y means reverse. Y is greater than or equal to x. Here also we will get these two events. X is more than y or y is more than x. They are called mutually exclusive events. Just like complements. If this is A, this is A complement. Now here also we take two special cases. We divide everything into two special cases. Here if I am say f z of z equal to, that is cdf of z equal to, probability that z is less than equal to z. But what is z? It depends upon two conditions. So I will write separately. Probability that z equal to x, I mean, so otherwise let me write capital z equal to x. X is less than or equal to z if, what a condition, x is greater than y, plus, why I am writing plus, because they are just like two complement events, a complement, plus, next, what will happen, here z will be equal to what now, y, means, observe carefully, y, in place of z I am writing y. Y less than equal to z, when z equal to y, when y is more than x, when y is greater than equal to x. Okay, here we have just find out these two probabilities for two separate cases. Is it okay? You observe the things properly. Now here we have drawn the graphs for two events, that is for x and this is for y. First of all, what we want? What we want? So, this is x equal to y line. And this is x equal to z. Z is some integer, some value. So, we want x less than or equal to z and x is more than y. So x should be less than or equal to z, at the same time x should be more than y. We have drawn two lines, x equal to y, this is a line, and x is more than y, which means x is more than y means what? To the right side of this line, isn't it? And x is less than z. This is x equal to z line. X is less than z means what? So this region indicates, let me indicate very carefully. This region is for what? X is more than y. Next, what they are saying? X should be less than or equal to z. This is x equal to z, straight line. Less than means to the left side of this line, this region. What this indicates? X is less than or equal to z. Now what is the common thing? This shape of this triangle. This is a common region. We would integrate over this region. Now next case. That is for first probability. This is x, this is y. What is the next case? y is less than equal to z and x is greater than equal to y. Here y should be less than equal to z, okay, at the same time y should be greater than equal to x. Here obviously this is x equal to y line, okay. Now here otherwise x should be less than equal to y. Can I write this as x is less than equal to y? Less than means very right, the left side of this line. So this is x is less than equal to y. Next, y, so this is nothing but y equal to z line. So y less than equal to z, y less than equal to z means this region. This is y is less than equal to z. So the common region would be this triangle. Now, so if observe these two triangles, if you superimpose this triangle, this is this like this. This is like this. What do you get? Can you guess? Anybody? You get something like this. The overall area is, what do you get? Like this. Two triangles. This is the overall area. For both cases, including both cases. Anyway, so here this is nothing but, what is this? So this is indicates x less than equal to z, y also less than equal to z. This area means less than equal to z, y also less than equal to z. Now what is this line? This is a line which indicates this point is z comma z, okay. Now anyway, so simply this is nothing but x is less than equal to z, y also less than equal to z, okay. Now here what you get here is the CDF of z equal to probability that x is less than equal to z and y also less than equal to z. What is this definition of this is what? Simply this is joint CDF of z comma z. So you got this CDF. Now what about PDF? Just differentiation. So here also if they are independent, what happens? If x and y are independent, what do you write? So here the CDF of z, see please here I am writing CDF only, not PDF. If z of z equal to, what will happen? CDF of x as a function of z into CDF y as a function of z, or CDF calculated at z. Please make a note of this. They are CDFs, not PDFs. If you know CDF, you can get a PDF just by differentiation. That is not a big deal. Okay. Now, so let us take some problems. You read this problem properly. What is it saying? Two archers shoot target. The distance of each shot from the center of the target is uniform distributed 0 to 1. So shooters are there. Okay. First of all, it is uniform distributed, no? So this is a PDF. 0 to 1, 1. Independently of other shot. So both are independent. What is the PDF of the distance of the losing shot from the center? Okay, so here let us take, there is a target. So two persons are, this is a target, let us take. Now this is x, this is y. The distance from the center target is x and y. Who will lose? Who is far away from the target? Which means, if x and y are distances, okay. Now suppose this should be the target actually, this should be the shot. But x is here, y is here. Y is far away from the target. Who is a loser? Y is a loser. If x and y are distances, who is a loser? Maximum of x comma y. Whoever is shot away from the target, that person is a loser, isn't it? Now, so that is simple logic. Now here, what happens here? If x and y are distances from the target, shot by two archers, now distances from the target shot by two archers, and what they are given in the problem, they are uniformly distributed. In the range of 0 to 1. And also one more thing they told us, that they are independent. What they are? They are independent. Who is a loser? There is a loser. Let us take. PDF of the loser we want. That means maximum of x comma y. Do you agree or not? So here, this is a, let us take, this is the dot. So this is a target. But so this should be the shot first. This is a target. So suppose person X shot here, person Y shot here. Who is the loser? Who is far away from the target? Here, who is the loser? X. Simply, whoever is shooting far away from the target, that person is a loser. How to find out? Measure distance of these two from the target. If the distance is maximum, that person is a loser. If the distance is minimum, that person is the winner. So simply find out the maximum of two distances, x and y. So x and y both are independent and uniformly distributed random variable in the range of 0 to 1. Now they are asking the PDF of z. They are asking, what is the PDF of z? But we know that just now we discussed. What have we discussed? The CDF of z equal to what? What? Fx of z and into Fy of z. Please remember, they are CDFs, not PDFs. Okay. Why I am writing like this? Because it is given in the problem that they are independent. But what we know, first of all, we know that x and y are what? Two uniform distributed random variables in the range of 0 to 1. 0 to 1 x is the PDFs of x and y. And one more way of writing this is 0 to 1, 1, this is fy of y, y. Now, so what we have to find it here is fz of z equal to fx of z into fy of z. CDFs calculated at z. CDF calculated at z. First of all, so let us go to the definition of this part. What is that? This says that x is less than equal to z. That is the definition of CDF. What this says? Probability that random variable y is also less than equal to z, isn't it? Yes or no? Okay, suppose z is here. Okay, can you find out this? What is this probability? So I will find out one probability. Probability that x is less than equal to z. What we know? We know p def of x 0 to 1, this we know x. Now suppose z is here. Simply, what the probability of x less than equal to z means this area. What is this area? Z into 1, this is z. Now what about next probability? Probability that y is less than equal to z. We know the p def of y, it is also uniformly distributed in the range of 0 to 1. 0 to 1, this is y, this is 1. Suppose z is here. So probability that y is less than equal to z means this region. What is area? This is also z. This is a rectangle, no? Z into 1, z. So here what you got? Fz of z equal to fx of z into fy of z. Fx of z, both are z, z square. This is the cdf of z. What about pdf? Which means we have to do what? Differentiation. So the pdf of z equal to fz of z equal to, what do you get? What a differentiation of 2z, z square. This is 2z if it is between 0 and 1. Okay, sorry. 2z if it is between 0 and 1. 0 otherwise. Isn't it? Okay. Okay, now so the last one would be ordered statistics. I told you W equal to minimum of x comma y. This is one more way of writing. Now what W will be now? When it is minimum, suppose if W equal to x, let me take y means y is minimum. Means what? X is more than y. X means x is minimum, means y is more than x. Now what is fw of w? That equal to probability that w will be less than equal to small w. Means what do you write? This is again, yeah, same thing happened. There are two mutually exclusive events. Now you can write probability as sum of two probabilities. Probability that y will be less than equal to w, given that x is more than y, plus probability that x is less than equal to w, given y is more than or equal to x. Anyway, so I'm not doing all the calculations again and again, so I'll simply write the simple formula. If w of small w equal to fx of w plus fy of small w minus fxy of small w. Now you must know this also, very, very, very important. Okay, right. So here, so far you are discussing z equal to x plus y, x minus y, x by y, what else? Maximum of x comma y, minimum of x comma y. So for each and everything you must know the corresponding what? What do you know? Corresponding PDF, fz of z. In all these cases, all these five cases, you must know what is the corresponding PDF of z. Here? Okay. So, right. So, we stop here. Thank you.